Welcome to the Valley of the Sun, Phoenix International Raceway. Now, PIR is one of the most scenic tracks on the NASCAR circuit. This is Rick Allen, and this one-mile oval raceway is tricky to maneuver, especially with the dogleg in the middle of the backstretch.
Woo! 29th from 40th. Yes! It'd been the hood all the hell to get it, but we got it. That track was hard. The track is so short. And to get in the car to turn, the car just does not want to turn left. It's time to turn left, it's climbing the wall. Let out of the gas, and you're still climbing the wall. All right, got Phoenix under our belt. Let's get the next one. One thing I've found about this game is that you don't go, if you go straight from go into it, and it gives you a chance to practice for 59 minutes. If you don't take about 15 to 30 minutes practicing and getting the hang of learning the track and getting the car to want to turn by changing the air pressure in the tires and try to get the most speed you can, you won't finish well at all. So that's, from my point of view, that's what's really helpful, is keep, you do the practice or do some of it, and then go ahead and jump into a race, get your qualifying, and then jump into a race and try to drive. And in the career mode, every time you get a chunk of money and you can upgrade your garage into working on the car, it'll help the performance of your car, not only your speed, but also your ability to turn. And this track is so tight, the turns are so tight, that there's not much of a bank, and you're going along at high speed, you turn the wheel, and all you do is head up to the wall. So it was an interesting track. But we did not finish last, and we got in the low, what, the high 20s? So we did good. Let's keep up the pace. It's very aggressive driving, but I didn't want to finish last. Because we can't afford the last. We gotta get paid. Because if your car won't turn, you gotta get around as many cars as you can. Get around as many other competitors as you can. So when you take those turns and the turns slow you down, you're not right back at the end of the pack. He put on the brakes and I had to hammer down. The guy in front of me, oh no, no, I gotta slow down. The 27 or something in front of me going, wanting to slow down. No, 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 we're not slowing down, dude. We gotta go, 23. Yeah, he's wanting to drive slow. You wanna drive slow? Get out of the way. We gotta go. Bye-bye, Geico. Be seeing ya. There he is. $10,927. Woo! Big payday! Oh, we're in 33 on points. Yeah, that's fine.
Time for a little glitz and glamour as NASCAR rolls into Auto Club Speedway, located just east of Hollywood, California. Only today, it's here where someone's dreams are going to come true. This fast and wide racetrack has aged quite a bit and developed multiple grooves for passing opportunities. Will we see another Hollywood finish today? Today we come to you from the oldest and shortest track in NASCAR, Martinsville Speedway. Hello everyone, I'm Rick Allen. They call this place the paperclip due to its shape. For over 60 years, NASCAR drivers have struggled to nail down the right setup to go both fast and be able to pass.
My way.
All clear low. You're all clear. All low. The trouble is turn one. All low. All high. There's a wreckage. Turn four. You're all clear. All clear. All low.
Finished 19th. A little top down. Some real good view on that action. Aggressive driving. This track was really hard because on that turn, I think it's the turn three, you come around that turn, you gotta be careful if you're on the inside because it'll suck you into the pits. And if it sucks you into the pits, that's it for your race, because you'll be a lap down by the time you get out of there. That turn's so tight. A little action behind me there. Behind us. It's the first time I finished a race and this not in the teens. Okay, in this replay, I'll show you how it went at the final race. I raced this track three times. The first two times, in turn four, where the entrance to the pit is, if you're too low, it will automatically pull you into the pits, and then you're a lap down and your race is done. You can't catch up then. And by this time, I was very angry and just trying to get it over with. And actually finish the race in a decent position. So I am super aggressive and maybe even somewhat dirty, trying not to finish in 40th. So that's the explanation for what's going on. $16,848. That's a real good payday. We're doing on points. 32nd.